from 2022, which is next year, until 2026, for the next 5 years period, we will have 6 manufacturers. 3 from Europe, KTM, Aprilia and Ducati, and 3 from Japan, Suzuki, Honda and Yamaha. So for a manufacturer to compete in the World Championship, of course you have to follow the technical regulation, which is 1000cc, 4 cylinders, you know, using a 1 ECU. But the rest is at your discretion and you know, do whatever you want to do. A manufacturer is a manufacturer, a constructor that wish to enter MotoGP championship to show their know-how, their technology. They have 2 ways to enter the championship. Either do it as a factory team, which means they own the team, they own the spot, and they are owning the contract with the staff and the riders. But also they can supply independent team with same machine, same spec, but these teams, which we call independent teams, they are run in an independent way. Together with Dorna and IRTA, we have been working really hard to convince the manufacturer that it is in their own interest to supply the same level of machinery to the independent team. In the past, we used to have a 1-year-old, sometimes 2-year-old machinery, and it was very difficult to compete against the manufacturers. But now we try to explain to the manufacturer that they have interest in giving us the same level of machine for them to have the right data in order to develop the bike, and also for them, through the independent team, to check young riders' potential for the future. So now I think we are in a dream scenario where almost all the machines on the starting grid in 2022 will be 2022 spec, all of them same level. Right now at the moment, some manufacturers still don't decide to support any team, like Suzuki, Aprilia, I said. Other manufacturers can expand a lot, like Ducati, who will provide 8 machines. So the ideal format would be 6 manufacturers, each manufacturer's 2 factory bikes, 2 bikes in an independent team, which means 6x4, 24. In order to have more constructor and manufacturer in our championship, we created the concession system. It was to help a new manufacturer joining the championship to develop in a quicker way to catch back the current manufacturer already in place. And that was giving them more engine, more testing possibilities to speed up the process. And this has worked really well. This has helped Suzuki to come back. This has helped Aprilia to come back. And this has decided KTM to join. Of course, when you are a manufacturer without any concession, if you don't do any podiums during the season, you can lose your status and get concession again for the future. Again, the target is to have the manufacturer very close to each other to produce exciting racing, a great show. And then anybody who is not performant enough receive concession to catch back. Manufacturers are entering MotoGP Championship to show their technology, their know-how, and of course to participate to this great show. So clearly, no parts are exchangeable. What we have in common is the 1 ECU, which is organized by the championship, by the promoter, and the 1 tire, which are Michelin. The rest is all specifically developed by each manufacturer. You can see that on some circuit, some technology is a bit better and some bikes are maybe a bit more agile through the slow corner to change direction. Some other manufacturer put more the focus on top speed to have a very fast engine. And at the end of the day, what they all manage to do is to be very close in terms of performance, but not achieving this performance with the same technology, which is very good because it is helping the championship to be very open. And we know, for example, that when we go to the new circuit, maybe some manufacturer will have an advantage, but when we go to the next one, maybe others will have an advantage. And this is what makes MotoGP exciting on the technology point, but also exciting on the sporting department.